Ladies and gentlemen, I'm John Gray, and this is Just Plain Living.
Good morning. I'm Peggy Burton.
And I'm Jim Fuller.
Good to be here.
It's good to be here.
Yeah.
No get out of jail free card, right?
That's right. Chief's on the show today, and we just ask if somebody interviewed the chief and talked nice to him and get out of jail free card.
Yeah.
I think he said the printer broke.
Yeah. You know, the sad thing about all that is, John, there was a time in mine and your life where we could have used to get out of jail free card.
But
those days are way behind us.
Are you done?
Yes. Yeah.
Done with goofing.
We're done with that kind of stuff anyway.
That's fact. Hey. Yesterday was Memorial Day.
Yesterday was
Memorial Day.
Yes, it was.
And we have a couple of flags flying back here right now, and I just want to say thank you to everyone in the military.
Me too.
All the veterans and all the families of those who didn't come home. We absolutely thank you for your sacrifice and your service, and we certainly send you all the respect and love in the world.
Thank you. I feel the same way. My flag flew low yesterday.
You know, there were several volunteer organizations spent a tremendous amount of time putting flags on the graves.
That's a beautiful sight.
Veterans, and I know that we talked with one of the Girl Scout troops, it escapes me the number at the moment, and also the Civil Air Patrol. And the Civil Air Patrol happened to be at Rose Hill Memorial Gardens, and they were telling me that there was over 1,000 veterans buried there.
I did not know that.
Yeah, and that's quite a job.
A huge job.
Yeah, and you know, of course, they have to locate them, but they are at Rose Hill. I noticed they are marked on the.
They're marked on the tombstones, I think.
Yes.
And get the flags and put the flags out there.
Yeah.
And go back and pick the flags
up.
Store the flags.
Yeah, you know, and it's kind of
a big operation.
Operation. I think the VFW here in Tullahoma
basically sponsors it. Maybe
they actually furnish all the flags, mm-hmm. and of course keep the flags in the when they're not being used. And these various, I guess, the Girl Scouts and the Civil Air Patrol do the. And maybe some other people in Tullahoma actually helped make that happen for them. And
I know until they found another place, the First Christian Church, which now is our annex, was the old post office, and we stored the flags there for them.
Office.
They were right. They had racks set up to where the sticks would go in a certain way.
And the next time.
Yeah, where they didn't get wrinkled and messed up. So yeah, it's a big operation.
You know, when I was doing that with the American Legion, who I worked for many years, as most of you know, we were going out there sticking them in the ground and didn't have that good a plan.
Mm-hmm. Right,
25
right.
years ago.
But you now were doing it. That's
now,
what
now they've got this little tool.
Yeah.
You go up there and tap it once, and it's
and
got
it, goes,
it,
it
makes
goes,
the hole.
Hole's perfect.
The hole's perfect. Yeah, I mean, they got this figured out now, you know. So.
Yeah, that's it. Modern technology, man.
Absolutely.
Won't be long, you'll have a little laser you can just take a.
Yeah.
And
then
there'll
be the hole.
You can do that from home.
Do it from home.
There's probably an app for that.
Young kids remember. I hope there's enough promotion on this that young children get it.
I do too, and I took the time yesterday because it was on all day long on mm-hmm. one of the channels. I believe it was 58 on Charter, and I rewatched Private Ryan.
Oh my gosh, that's tough.
And if you haven't seen that, you know, it's something you need to find a time and plan time to watch that movie. It's an incredible movie, and of course, Tom Hanks is just
incredible,
stellar in everything he does, but that story is just a phenomenal story, and it's Steven Spielberg produced it, and it's worth your time to watch that.
I know.
Did you actually watch it from beginning to end?
Yes.
Yeah.
Well, it took me about three times to get
that's
it from
what I started
beginning
saying.
To
now, that's the way I watch TV. I never see anything from beginning to end.
Oh, yeah, I do that.
You know,
I do that.
And you'll see a piece of it here uh-huh. and a piece of it later.
Sometimes it comes on twice.
Yeah.
And you see the end first and go back
ultimately,
to the beginning.
Ultimately, you've seen it all. But
my husband couldn't watch that. You know, he
I can understand that.
He would not go to see it. It was sometimes the memories were too hard.
Yeah, yeah, I understand that. I do. And we also have on today's show, I stopped by the Life Care Center, and there was a group, again, from First Christian Church down there singing patriotic songs.
Great.
And it was really fun. A lot of the ladies and gentlemen there, the residents of Life Care, had their hats on, and they were singing along.
That's
and it
good.
Was it was
yeah.
Bring a tear to your eye and make you smile all at the same time.
Mm-hmm. That,
you know,
that's
so
nice.
It's good stuff. We, you know, we have a lot of good stuff goes on
we
around
do.
This
we
town,
do.
And a lot of very very
all the churches
good people
saluted the military pretty much at Sunday service.
And flags
and
were flying.
Flags were flying
low as they should be. And
I noticed a lot were not though. That's the first thing I did. I got up that morning and went out and let my flag down. Yesterday morning, and let my flag down.
Yeah. Which is what you're supposed to do.
Right.
Right.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Right.
Right.
And I never, I've been told, and I forget, as at half mast, is the top of the flag halfway down the flagpole, or the bottom of the flag halfway down the flagpole?
I think it's the top, but I could be wrong.
Halfway
I see nobody responding.
You mean?
Or is it right in the middle?
Down.
Or is it right in the middle?
I think it's basically
of the flag.
And I think the important thing is that it's down.
It's down. But I guarantee you, there's a speck somewhere.
Yeah, there definitely
is.
On whether that,
because
if it's at the bottom, then the flag's flying above half mast.
Mm-hmm.
If it's at the top, then it's flying below half mast. Or should it be right in the middle?
Well, let's research
that. Yeah, and the wind was blowing beautiful yesterday, and the flags were standing out. It was just gorgeous. It was gorgeous. Good day.
It's like when you go to an auditorium, and if the flag is on the wrong side. Now, to my knowledge, the flag of the United States should be stage right, which if you're looking at the stage, it's to your left.
Uh-huh.
Is that correct?
That is correct.
That is correct.
And
is correct.
I see it. Wrong
opposite
at the Civic Center sometimes, so I can go up there and
change it.
And
it
also,
over.
If you have other flags, the American flag
should be the tallest.
Should be in, mm-hmm. and in front, slightly to the front.
Right.
So right.
We all need to be conscious of those things, and I think it's good to teach that in school. Do they do the Pledge of Allegiance anymore? I mean,
I think they do.
I hope they do. Yeah.
Well, it's getting hard to tell because, you know, you're going to make somebody mad. This is a diverse nation, and there's people that think the flag shouldn't even be flown.
Well, then those people need to move somewhere else.
You know, I agree. I understand that
right on.
I understand that there's different religions that might make people feel uncomfortable. Certainly, we got through it when we were in school. But now the flag and Pledge of Allegiance, that's if you live here.
You need to be doing that.
You need to be doing that.
I think so.
That's right.
So that's our opinion.
We'll hear
from somebody, I guarantee
we need
you
to
that.
Have a Twitter conversation.
This is...
You written a poem?
I'm going to use that later.
Okay.
What I'm going to say right now is tomorrow, Wednesday, the 27th of May...
Is
Fran Gray's birthday.
Whoa,
that's
happy,
happy birthday to you.
Happy birthday to you.
How about switching the camera?
Wait a minute.
Here we go. Happy birthday to you.
Wow.
What about that, huh? Now,
she'll be 36, won't she?
Yes, she will. 36.
Okay. Love it. She's a good girl.
This is for you. To my true love, I write these words with true respect and pride. For God alone, right or wrong, has put you by my side. One of the treasures of the past walks among us still. In timeless elegance and grace, my lovely Southern Belle. Straw hats hanging on the wall to shade an ivory face, while walking down a meadow's path filled with Queen Anne's lace. The legacies from times gone by are reverently displayed, reminders of a way of life you'll not allow to fade. A Southern bell is ringing still, its music in my wife, gracious gentlewomanhood was reborn through her life. I gained a jewel of wealth unmatched by the richest king when on our wedding day I gave my Southern Belle a ring. Like antique lace, her simple grace was stitched by ladies gone on garden walks and parlor talks and picnics on the lawn. The blossom anchored to the roots of lessons she learned well became the flower of my life, my lovely Southern Belle. I love
you,
dear.
Sweet. That was really sweet.
That's my girl. That is
You're
my
lucky
girl.
To have her.
I'm lucky to have her.
Yes,
she,
you are.
I figured she'd have kicked me to.
She's put up with you.
I'd have figured she'd have kicked me to the curb a long time ago,
yeah.
You know. But she hadn't.
That's what
she's
had.
She's held on.
That's. It's kind of like that deal of the chief doesn't have to worry about you and I getting any trouble anymore. And Fran got through all the rough years. It's,
yeah.
It's smooth sailing
well,
now.
You know, it's rough. Now. It's you know, being married is rough on everybody. It's not easy. It's not an easy thing to stay married 41, 42, 50 years.
It is.
And it
if
takes.
You
well, no. I mean, it takes give and take from everybody and
well,
understanding.
It does, yeah.
And,
it's not. And, it's not even a 50-50. It's like a
60-60.
75 or something.
It's a 60-60 yeah. Or 75-75. That's right.
41 years.
This year, yeah.
Cool.
That's that'll be in September.
Yeah.
That'll be in September.
41
so.
Is good.
Yeah.
I know a lot of people that have been married 40, 50 years, but usually it's to multiple partners.
Yeah.
So. Actually, me being one of them, I guess.
I'll tell you what, with that said, what we're going
to
do is take a quick commercial break, and we will be back with the rest of today's show. Don't you go away. There's great things happening around here and a lot of good things to see right here on Just Plain Living.
We get closer to a world with more birthdays. When we take cancer patients by the hand, we help them find answers and guidance and hope, and give them more candles to light. We're the American Cancer Society. Help create a world with more birthdays at morebirthdays.com.
Serving you as a local firefighter.
Proudly served our country in the United States Air Force.
Serving Tullahoma.
Helping our kids.
Hi, I'm Terry Stroop. Your comfort is our service. We'd like to thank Tullahoma for the privilege of serving your heating and cooling needs.
When your family suffers the loss of a loved one, the caring and compassionate staff at Tullahoma Funeral Home and Coffee County Funeral Chapel are standing by to assist you in every way possible. We are proud to support local industry and offer only Batesville caskets. Many funeral homes don't own or operate a crematory. We utilize the only crematory in Coffee County. Your loved one never leaves Coffee County. We can accommodate any need and any budget. Consider our complete pre-need service to remove this burden from your family during their time of grief. Lock in today's low costs and protect from inflation. Tullahoma Funeral Home and Coffee County Funeral Chapel. Our family caring for your family.
Welcome back, ladies and gentlemen. We're pleased to have joining us on the set now from Shelbyville, Tennessee, Virginia Stewart, who is a good friend of ours. You've met her probably before through the walking horse industry that we've talked to Virginia a few times on another show. And also we're pleased to have with us also Jack Pirtle, who's in the automobile business in Shelbyville. And that's Shelbyville Ford, is that correct?
Correct.
All right, outstanding. And Virginia, I know you guys are dealing with a charity that's very dear to your heart.
Excellent.
And it involves helping cancer patients. Tell us a little bit about your
it's
charity.
It's the Bedford Cancer Foundation, and we are a nonprofit, totally local. We're not affiliated with any other organization, and we help people who have financial difficulties due to having cancer. Sometimes people lose their jobs, they can't work. We don't hand out cash, but we will maybe pay rent, pay utility bills, give them a card to buy groceries, and we do have to have a doctor's, you know, authorization that they are indeed, you know, do have cancer. And It's just a worthwhile organization. It really is. And the money stays local.
In Bedford County,
yes.
Is that correct? Now, and I would imagine that you encounter this a lot, that even though people might have insurance,
or
there are a lot of other expenses associated with trying to deal with that
absolutely.
Issue.
Absolutely. I mean, just some of them have trouble with having the money for gas to get back and forth to, say, Vanderbilt or something. But there are a lot of side expenses. And as I say, they might have insurance, but they may not can be working.
Mm-hmm.
And they've lost their income.
Mm-hmm.
So I believe very strongly in what we're doing. I mean, just some of the, as I use the term, some of the cases are gut-wrenching. They really are sad. And so Jack's on our board,
mm-hmm.
and we were just thrilled to have him join the board a couple of years ago. And so that's our organization.
I can only imagine that you guys probably, being the type of organization you are, and I know you have your own board of directors, mm-hmm. and you're local and deal with the Bedford County area, that you're probably able to react a lot quicker than maybe a government type agency
absolutely.
Or something like that when someone has an issue.
Now, we do have an application that they must fill out. We have a committee on the board that reviews it first, and someone always talks to that individual, and then the committee brings it back to the board, and the board then decides,
mm-hmm.
Makes the final decision.
Okay, and you're on the board as well.
That's
Jack.
Correct. Yeah. And the beauty of all this, in my opinion, is 100% of the contribution that's made to the board,
mm-hmm.
Goes to the people that need it the most.
Mm-hmm.
And as you get older, you realize how many lives have been touched by this disease. And as Virginia said, it's not just the insurance, but, going through chemotherapy treatments or radiation treatments, and some of these are 5 days a week, it catches people at their toughest time. And, I think it's a big support to the people that need it the most. As Virginia says, they may be commuting from Shelbyville or Bedford County to Murfreesboro to Nashville, wherever they have to go. And being able to provide assistance for these folks is very rewarding and hopefully a big help to them. And what we've seen, it has been.
You know, Jack, you said something that I think is pretty significant here, and that is that the number of people that are going to be touched by this, whether it be something that happened to you or something that happened to a close relative, a close friend, or whatever. I don't remember exactly the numbers, but it's something like 70% maybe, or 60-70% of people are going to know someone, mm-hmm. or have a family member that is touched by cancer.
Absolutely. It's very high. I don't know the percentage either, but
yeah.
I mean, you just talk to people. Most everybody has a relative or a dear friend that has experienced cancer.
Virginia, I know you specifically have been involved in this for quite some time. What motivated you to get into this to begin with and start this organization?
I lost a good many of my family members to cancer. My mother, my sister, my mm-hmm. aunt, my grandmother. We were fortunate that we, had the insurance and, that type of thing. But I just feel so strongly about any kind of cancer program and wanting to help.
I can absolutely see Virginia doing that. We kid about Virginia on our walking horse program a lot because Virginia has walking horses, and when they get too old to perform, she calls them yard ornaments, I think. It's that they get to stay around, she feeds them and all that kind of stuff. Just because they get too old to show doesn't mean that they're not well.
They're too old,
well,
they just didn't make it.
Yeah, they make it, yeah.
I have a hard time selling my babies.
Yeah, right, yeah, they're babies. Let's talk a little bit about, I know you do the horse show as a fundraiser, and this year you're adding a dimension, and that's where Jack comes into this.
Right. The Walking for Cancer Horse Show is Saturday, June the 6th, starts at 5 o'clock, and it's our major fundraiser. And Jack I'm going to let him tell you about the drive for your community portion of it.
Okay, and that's going to be fun, Jack.
It will. We're very fortunate. Ford Motor Company offers the opportunity to do, as Virginia said, Drive for Your Community charity event. And what this entails is for Chevyville Ford provides the vehicles as far as the demonstration vehicles for each test drive that we have. Ford donates $20 per test drive, mm-hmm. up to $6,000. Mm-hmm. Our challenge is you must be 18 years of age, have a valid driver's license, mm-hmm. and it's one per household.
Right.
So having the horse show in conjunction with the drive for Bedford Cancer Foundation, the more people we could bring together quickly, the better off we would be. Like I said, $6,000 is a lot of money, and we want to make sure we don't leave a dime on the table.
So
we need 300 test drives.
Right.
This is not a sale. We're not over trying to sell cars. It's just to let people see a new Ford product, technology, and so forth. But it is truly an event to raise money for a fabulous, fabulous organization.
Yeah, and you're doing this at the same time you're doing the horse show. Is that correct?
Absolutely.
Oh, yeah, great.
This is going to start at 3, right?
Correct. We're going to start at 3 by the Blue Ribbon Circle, and we'll get it going there. And if we need to move it around or do whatever we need to do, we look to maximize this as much as we possibly can.
Okay.
The horse show is at the Champions Arena this year on Celebration Ground.
Uh-huh.
It's always been at the Ag Center in the past, but it is at Champions Arena this year. And as he said, the cars will be in front of the Blue Ribbon Room, and that starts at 3. The horse show starts at 5.
And they don't have to be Bedford County residents to come test drive.
That's absolutely correct.
Did I hear you say that something else, that one per family or one per household?
It's one per household. If it were a household, we would we'd be looking for some large families to be quickly.
Exactly. Okay, one per household, but you don't necessarily have to be from Bedford County.
No.
Because a lot of people, I'm sure, buy cars from you guys.
Sure.
That don't live in Bedford County.
Right.
Okay.
And like I say, with $6,000 available, that's 300 test drives, $20 a piece, $6,000, could go a long way in helping someone that is going through probably one of the tougher things that they would ever face in their life.
Yeah, and folks, if you're out there driving around in a 2005 or 6 vehicle, it may still be good. There's a lot of technological advances that have occurred in the last few years that are available on some of these new Ford products, so you need to get over there and check it out. Champions Arena, by the way, is a great venue to have this. It's covered, so you don't have to worry so much about the rain or anything else, and not only that, it's a great place to put those Ford vehicles over there so people can come look at them. Again, what was the date?
Saturday, June the 6th.
Saturday, June the 6th. Okay. All right. So check it out, folks. The horse show probably starts about 6, right?
5.
Okay. And you can do the test drive starting at 3, Jack?
3 p.m.
3?
At the Blue Ribbon Circle is where we'll be located at that point.
Right. So help them out with that, folks. For goodness sakes, I mean, you're going to enjoy going over there doing the test drive. You're also probably going to enjoy that horse show as well.
And so, the food and the homemade desserts.
Right.
So come on out.
I'd forgot about that. That's a big part of it. Big part of it, folks. The food and the homemade desserts.
A great horse show.
Right. All right, coming up on June the 6th, folks, thank you guys for coming by today, and thank you for what you do to help cancer patients in the Bedford County area.
Thank
folks,
you.
We'll be right back in just a moment with more Living right after this.
Are you tired of getting those letters in the mail being turned down for that new car? Due to bankruptcy, medical expenses, or divorce? Then look no further than Russell Barnett Kia. Good credit, bad credit, no problem. Here at Russell Barnett Kia, we are your bank. Dial 931-455-6066 or visit us on the web at russellbarnett.com. And remember, we are the bank and we can help you. Good credit, bad credit, no problem. Why buy anywhere else?
It's your trademark. that something special everyone knows and remembers. It's your thing. It's made holidays special for decades, and summers unforgettable for the entire neighborhood. It's made everyone laugh every single time. Don't let illness or injury keep you from doing your thing. The rehab team at Life Care Center of Tullahoma is ready to help you live well.
Get your news first, fast, and free with your news leader on 6 every Tuesday, Thursday, and Saturday nights at 6, 8, and 10 p.m. Local weather, sports, community calendar events, and a comprehensive look at the latest news stories and newsmakers as only a video news broadcast can do. Get it first, fast, and free with News Leader on Channel 6, your local information network.
All right, folks, we're back, and it's time, and I'm really feel honored today because I get to interview Chief Blackwell, and it's time for Police Pointers, and, you know, Chief comes on every 2 weeks and talks to us about different things, and, you know, I worked on the Chief for about a year to get him convinced that this was a good thing to do, and the reason it started is because I didn't think people knew what to do at a four-way stop. And it's been what now?
That's over two years.
2 years.
Yes.
Mm-hmm. And, you know, there's so many things that go on, and people have questions about stuff from time to time. And I know we're at graduations this weekend.
Right.
And so summertime is here, and young people are going to be on the streets. We have a new swimming pool that's getting ready to open up. And so, are there any things that really come to mind about getting ready for that type of activity, things that you and your force do, and maybe stuff that people at home, latchkey kids, how they deal with summertime?
Yeah. Now, if I was in a courtroom, I'd say, what question do you want me to answer? You can't throw 30 questions.
Just summertime. Yeah.
And it's always something going on, and that's, you know, when we're out in public, we, police officers, city employees, people are always asking about activities. When are they going to do this again? Or, you know, what time does this start this weekend? So there is a lot that goes on, and we city employees become ambassadors for the city. So from a police department standpoint, our officers have to be aware of community events so that they can either provide an answer or provide a resource to go find out. One of the things that I try to impart on officers and anyone I speak to is, I don't know is not an acceptable answer. We may not have the answer to a particular question, but we should be prepared to give who you can call or who you can get in touch with to get the answer. Mm-hmm. So, you know, it could be, we don't know the answer, but here's someone that can help you.
Right.
And that's one of the things that I always try to make sure officers understand. And I don't like hearing that, I don't know, or there's nothing we can do. There's always something we can do.
Well, you know, one thing that's helped me is Mayor Curley has started putting out a monthly calendar that has a lot of events that are taking place in the city on that.
It does.
And I think that's very helpful.
Yes, and Mayor Curley has got a lot of things on the calendar. There's a lot of things that go on in the community. In fact, one of the things I wanted to mention, just a week and a half ago, we had our police memorial ceremony down at South Jackson, and with many thanks to your wife, she has helped us quite a bit. She sings a solo, God Bless America, kind of sets the tone. But we had good weather.
Yep.
The trees are starting to blossom, and it was like, this is a great setting. Right. Give these trees a couple more years when the
Aren't
canvas.
Aren't they going to be beautiful? Yeah,
when we get a really nice. A real canopy,
right.
It's going to be really nice down there at the flagpole. Well attended, like I say, the weather was great. Harton Hospital sponsored our reception, and that's sometimes the more enjoyable part because everybody just sits around and visits and talks. So that was a very good program. Tonight, we will have our graduation from our second Citizens Police Academy. That'll culminate 10 weeks of getting together with 11 members of the community and sharing with them what we as police officers do, mm-hmm. how the police department's organized, how it's structured.
Right.
So we'll have that graduation tonight. And it's kind of this is the busy time of the year for myself and the staff because we have to put a lot of this together.
Right.
And then we'll kind of get a little lull for a while.
No, that's when that swimming pool will open.
Well, and that's when the other activities come into play, the city activities.
Right, right.
You know, these two that we're talking about are primarily police department
right.
centered. But now we will have a lot of things. The swimming pool scheduled to open, you know, hopefully pretty soon.
Right.
You know, Friday.
Excuse me, I'm sorry.
Friday night, TUB had their movie in the park. So we had to send officers out to that. Mm-hmm. Last week, the Bicycle Club had their ride of silence through town on Wednesday. My wife and I participated in that, got our bikes out and rode with mm-hmm. them. Our bicycle patrol escorted them along with some officers in the cars. So there is a lot that goes on, and you've got to, as you said, either watch those calendars, watch the newspaper to see what's going on, what you can participate in. And there are a lot of activities for the kids that are going to be out in the summer. I know Parks and Recreation, they keep a very busy schedule.
Busy schedule, the library.
Yes.
That whole area up there around the swimming pool and Codes and D.W. Wilson and the ballparks, you know, that's going to be an area here as soon as that place opens up that, you know, people are really going to need to be conscious when they're going down that mm-hmm. street, those streets, that there's going to be a lot of activity there.
Yes.
People turning in, maybe more traffic on those roads than normal.
And there's going to be some changes in the flow of traffic
right.
when the pool opens. And those are all things that Mayor Curley has, you know, reviewed and approved, and the board and mayor and aldermen have looked at. But like you say, when that is finished, there'll be the swimming pool complex, the recreation complex, the baseball fields, Imagination Station, the library, the senior citizens.
Right.
That is going to
That's
be
a hot spot.
A hot spot. All we need down there right now is a good food place.
Right.
You know,
right.
But yes, that's going to be exciting. As you go up Jackson Street, you see some new construction, and
right.
all of that is slated to open about summer, end
right,
of summer.
Right.
So you know, this is a community on the move.
Tullahoma's got a lot going on, and there's going to be there's something else coming in downtown. Christie has bought the old First National Bank building.
Mm-hmm.
And it's moving Merle Norman and Christie's Gifts and other businesses into that building, called the Downtown Avenues. So that's a whole new mm-hmm. mini mall type of a situation going in right on Atlantic Street downtown.
Yeah.
And so that's going to mean, you know, things are yeah. going and shaking and moving.
And the city's renovation for the downtown area.
Okay.
And I know a couple of the other businesses are doing some expansion as well. So it's going to be good. It's
right.
going to be busy. And, you know, when it comes back to the police standpoint, you know, we have to be conscious of all those activities and to see how does that affect us. Do we have to do some adjusting? Do we,
right.
you
right.
know, and it's always going. Progress is good. Yeah,
right.
I like
oh,
progress.
Sure, sure.
And you know, it's exciting to see and to hear when these things are occurring.
Right, right.
And as a police department, we just have to adjust and
well,
you know,
I know,
fit in.
I know, Chief, on the board meeting several times ago, you had your numbers, and you and Jimmy might have talked about that since then. But overall, just a broad scope of your numbers as far as crime and what? How did you feel about how that turned out this year?
The only thing that's really well, you know, any crime is concerning.
Sure.
But you look at some of the trends and, you know, our crimes against persons, which we would consider maybe our violent crimes,
mm-hmm.
are decreasing. Our crimes against property, we saw an increase. And when we start to look at some of those things, it's the same things I talk about here. Lock your cars at night.
Yeah.
You know, because we had the one individual last year that was responsible for about 50 car burglaries. And almost every one of them was unlocked. You know, so
right.
You know, we get frustrated that, come on, lock your cars or take your
lock
valuables
your door to your house.
Out, take your valuables out.
Right.
And then the other area that is really concerning is domestic violence. And it's not just Tullahoma, it's nationwide
right,
and statewide
right,
that
right.
Domestic violence makes up over 50% of our assault calls. And that's one of those things, it's very difficult for us to police it because
right.
it occurs in the privacy of your home,
right.
generally.
And,
now,
and
we can throw you in jail, you know, and
right.
but
you're going to get out.
If you get out and you go right back, or you allow the person to come right back
right,
into the,
right. that's a,
the setting.
That's a real, real, real difficult situation because a lot of those people who are being abused, and for some reason or another, feel like it's their fault.
Yeah.
And
again, it goes back to that. I don't want to say there's nothing we can do because there are a bunch of resources
right,
out
right,
there for people
right.
that feel trapped or not knowing which way to
right,
go or don't
right.
have the family support. There's a lot of resources out there, and we can provide that information
right,
to them.
Right. Well, folks, I'll tell you what. I am so glad this gentleman right here comes and visits with us. And, you know, we want you to know that the police are your friends. And if you have a question and you don't have an answer and you need help or you just want to, like I say, have a simple question, that the front door to the police station is open for anybody who wants to walk in there.
Right.
You don't need to have a complaint. You don't need to, it's just to find out information. These folks will be glad to help you.
And we have several people that do just stop in to say hello.
Yeah.
Just wanted to say hi to you.
And thank you.
You
I
know,
hope.
And a lot of them do. And, you know, and some people will talk about concerns.
Right.
I know we're getting short on time, but I believe the public wants really three things out of their police officers. They want honesty.
Right.
They want integrity, and they want accountability.
Right.
And that's what we strive to provide them because we work for you. I work
right.
for you.
Right.
And every officer works for the community as a whole. So nobody should feel we're not approachable, that they can't come and talk to us because we are your employees.
Right, and one thing you need to remember, folks, is you know, if you expect a police officer to walk up to your car, every car, with a smile on his face and a hand stuck out to shake your hand, don't expect that because that man has no idea what's going to be inside that car that he's going to.
But I do expect them to treat everybody
with
equally,
courtesy.
Fairly, and
right,
with courtesy. That's right.
There you go.
You know, and
but
if things,
y'all have a tough job.
Yeah. Every police officer should be able to be like a light switch.
You got it.
You know, our intent is to go out there and be, like as we said, you know, treat everybody honestly, fairly, with courtesy.
Right.
But if you have to flip that light switch, you got to be able to do it. And you got to be able to do it.
And be trained to do it.
Be trained to do it properly. That's correct.
Chief Paul Blackwell. Chief, thanks, buddy.
Thanks, John.
Appreciate it. We'll be back after these messages.
At the time, maybe you were just building a bridge, a business, or a community. Maybe you were simply working for a home or a better tomorrow. At the time, you served out of duty and love of country. But in that time, we see a legacy created, an American dream lived. The rehab team at Life Care Center of Tullahoma is ready to help you live well.
There's no place like home.
Getting home safely is just a click away. And choosing the right seat for your little one's age and size will take you down the road to safer travels.
How can I ever thank you enough?
Visit safercar.gov/the right seat.
I'm meteorologist Leland Statham from the News Channel 5 Weather Center. Look to Jim Fuller and crew for local news night here on Channel 6.
And back again with reference to Memorial Day, I want to read you something before we go to the Life Care video that I wrote for a wounded warrior friend of mine. It's called The Warrior. A young warrior stands in an ill wind. The battle still rages on without him. A leader of men both tall and strong, now fights with the moment where dreams are gone. A chill determination still shines in his eyes. But the enemy no longer fears his battle cries. His heart and his will still scream out for more, but the legs that he stands on can't take him to war. His comrades in combat still march glory bound as he fights with the feeling that he let them down. But there's strength in the fact that they still hold his dreams and they find inspiration each time he screams. A young warrior stands in an ill wind and dreams of the day when he fights again. The enemy will change. He must wait and see. But no matter the battle, a warrior he'll be. Yes, the enemy changes. That's life's way, you see. And no matter the battle, a warrior he'll be. And that's for all our wounded warriors out there. Thank you for your service. Life Care. Memorial Day at Life Care Center, Tullahoma.
Happy Memorial Day. We are so grateful to all of our veterans for their service.
All right, we're at Life Care Center, Tullahoma, and this is the First Christian Church Sunshine Singers are going to present a patriotic program to the residents here.
As I was from the cafeteria.
We are Goody Two Scoops.
I love Goody Two Scoops.
A family-friendly, yummy dessert specialty shop in Tullahoma, Tennessee. We excel in self-serve frozen treats and our own incredibly tasty chef-baked creations. For frozen treat lovers, we offer frozen yogurt, ice cream custard, as well as gelato and Italian ice. 85 flavors that rotate each day. 55 toppings, including fresh sliced fruit. For our baked good lovers, Goody Two Scoops offers a variety of fresh pastries at a hometown price. Our two certified culinary chefs design and create incredible cakes. We showcase our cakes, froyo cakes, cupcakes, cookies, pies, and chocolate-covered strawberries, offered fresh daily.
Nobody.
Goody Two Scoops.
Everybody has a dream. Mine was to see the ocean. And with a little help, I made it.
Get your news first, fast, and free with your news leader on 6 every Tuesday, Thursday, and Saturday nights at 6, 8, and 10 p.m. Local weather, sports, community calendar events, and a comprehensive look at the latest news stories and newsmakers as only a video news broadcast can do. Get it first, fast, and free with News Leader on Channel 6, your local information network.
You'll be glad you hung around. I'm here with Kathy Pelton from the Good Samaritan, and she's brought some wonderful people with her from Zaxby's. We have Mike Rutledge, no, backwards, Mike Forsythe and Shauna Rutledge with Zaxby's. They're into marketing, and you're doing a really big event, which really pleases me. So what do we call it?
It's the Tullahoma Hometown Throwdown.
Hometown Throwdown, and it's going to happen June the 6th.
Yes.
And how come, Mike, how come Zaxby's got involved in this? What made you get an inspiration to do this?
Well, from a personal standpoint, I've done a lot of fundraisers with different charities, and, you know, recently coming from the Boys and Girls Club board, just being new to Tullahoma and kind of learning about the Good Samaritan and their ministry, I wanted to get involved in a way that we could help in our community.
That's a beautiful plan. And I know that you're marketing director over several stores, and Shauna, you're a very young marketing person, mm-hmm. and I'm so proud of you. Comes from Manchester, Coffee County High School, and not too long ago.
Yeah.
You know,
about
so
5 years ago
years
now.
Ago,
yeah.
It goes really fast,
it does.
Doesn't it? So tell me about what your part in all this is.
We're just kind of organizing all of it. We're hosting it for them, so it's going to be right behind Zaxby's. There's a big lot back there. We've got vendors set up. We've got like live music. We're really just kind of putting it all together.
And this is, if you don't know where Zaxby's is, maybe you're from Suwanee. It's on the corner of North Jackson and what is that through street there? Do you
Cedar
know?
Lane.
Cedar Lane. Yeah, corner of North Jackson, Cedar Lane. You really can't miss it if you're coming down the main street in Tullahoma. But it happens June 6th, starts at 10 o'clock, I believe.
Yes,
and
ma'am.
Goes till 4.
Yes.
And I believe it's an event for all ages, right?
Yes, it is. Free event.
Oh, a free event. We need to push that.
Yes.
It is.
And
it
does
is.
The music start at 10 o'clock and follow through, or does it?
It will be an insert of some DJ music and yeah. another live band, so it will be from 10
okay.
to 4, all the whole session.
Now, I know the young man that was on the show last week was a member of the band that you, one of the bands that's going to be there. And what was the
that's
name of that?
Urban Policy.
Urban
mm-hmm.
Policy.
They're a local
really
band.
Cute.
I know, we
Didn't
were like, that's a
cute
name. Unique
that's
name.
A great
yeah.
name.
Very, very different.
Yeah.
Do you want to mention some of the vendors you have?
Yeah, we've got some Jamberry people coming out. We've got some just local crafters. We got like a unique boutique. We got some big ones like Verizon coming out, setting up booths. Oh,
Lowe's is contributing.
Yeah. Lowe's is contributing.
Tractor Supply.
A lot of different community and businesses coming
out. We hope that back behind me there, they will put the phone number up. Hopefully they're listening. I know they have it. There it is by magic. So now, why do they need a phone number?
If they want to make any donations, we're doing a silent auction, so we're auctioning off all kinds of stuff. And then also, we still have a few spots left for vendors. So if they, you know, they decide they want to do like an informational booth, we have those. You don't have to sell anything, or you can if you want to sell something. You can.
And you can always run into Zaxby's and get a good meal, or you can pick up stuff at some of the vendors.
That's right. We have information in multiple places throughout town: the Good Samaritan and Zaxby's, Regions Bank, Ascend, different people that you can get information from that we've partnered with.
We really have a very giving town, I think.
We do.
I think they're very generous. Kathy, where does some of the money go that's going to come to the Good Samaritan? What do you use some of the money for? I know, but tell us.
We use everything we can goes right back into helping the community. People in crisis situations and people just generally in need with things like utilities, rent, medications, sometimes an emergency dental extraction. When someone's in pain and they maybe have an abscess.
And for instance, if they are in pain and they have an abscess, you all help to pay for this service? Is that what happens?
Yes, we do. We do.
And that's...
So many people have no dental insurance
and
very little
to go.
Income, maybe on a very low fixed
disability. So if anybody does want to come to you for help,
yes.
Do they tell them where you were located?
We're at 315 East Grundy Street. That's where the ministry office is located.
It's real close to First Presbyterian, not whatever the church is there, Baptist. Isn't it close to Baptist Church?
Uh-huh. It's just down.
Yeah.
We're directly across diagonally across the street from Piggy's Place Barbecue.
And that's a good place, too. So
yes.
Anyway.
Yes.
Mike, how long have you been involved with the Tullahomas? By the way, there's a website. Zaxby's Tullahoma?
Yes, ma'am.
And if you want to get information,
that's
go
our
there.
Facebook page. You can go
your
on
Facebook
there.
Page, mm-hmm. Zaxby's Tullahoma. Okay, answer my question.
I've been with Zaxby's in Tullahoma since August, recently coming from Chick-fil-A, getting involved and trying to let people know that Zaxby's is part of the community and that we are here, you know, to help.
Well, I think this is a great way to make a tremendous positive impact.
Yes.
And what do you want people to take away from this today?
Well, as a consumer and a businessman, you know, entering in with Good Samaritans, it's basically got to look at their business. They help just a large number of people with, you know, especially during the holidays with meals and just so much that goes into that, that I think that if you just drove by, people wouldn't understand. But if you go in and you actually donate your time, or you actually meet with the people and can kind of see where
that's
that
right.
comes from, it's
kind
more to it.
Our food pantry.
There's a lot more to it than just your everyday practice.
And Kathy, I'm sure you're always looking for volunteers.
Yes, yes. We need volunteers to help us sort through the donations that are brought in and to help man the food pantry.
And if you're at home sitting on the couch whining because you don't have anything to do,
come join us.
Run down
Call
to see
me at the office.
Kathy at the office of Good Samaritan, because there are lots of things that a person that is older can help with,
yes.
or a younger person.
Yes.
There's a lot of people out there that do have time on their hands. And
yes.
I know we've got to go, but June the 6th.
10 to 4.
Is that Saturday?
It's a Saturday.
On a Saturday, 10 to 4. Out between Zaxby's and whatever's over there. And so bring your mom and them and everybody show up. It's going to be a wonderful event. Music, food,
bounce houses,
silent auctions,
wing eating contests.
Oh, okay, lots of stuff. Thank you so much.
Thank you.
Kathy,
thank you for
Mike, Shauna. Nice to meet you and lovely having you on the show. We'll be back.
Partners for Healing provides medical care to the working uninsured of Coffee, Franklin, and Moore counties. We are in Tullahoma from 8 to 5, Monday through Thursdays, and in Manchester on Fridays from 8 to 12. We provide primary medical care and offer an in-house disease management program.
My name is Rosie Mitchell, and I would just like to say I am blessed to have partners in my life.
Please call 455 5014 for more information. Thank you for being one of our Partners for Healing.
Hello, this is Janie Price. When my husband Ray Price would tour across the country, his favorite place to dine was Cracker Barrel Old Country Store locations. His favorite thing to order was the Uncle Herschel.
And the beauty of it all is forever, you'll be holding me too.
I miss Ray dearly, and I'm so proud that his last album, Beauty Is the Final Session, is available at his favorite restaurant.
A love affair.
The project includes a duet with Martina McBride and harmony vocals from Vince Gill. Ray believed this to be the best recording he had ever made.
Oh, I wish I was 18 again.
I think you'll agree when you pick up your copy of Beauty Is the Final Sessions at a Cracker Barrel Old Country Store location near you or at crackerbarrel.com.
A world without breast cancer is a world with more birthdays. And signing up for the Making Strides Against Breast Cancer Walk will help us get there faster. The American Cancer Society invests in groundbreaking breast cancer research, and we're part of every community. In fact, one in two women newly diagnosed with breast cancer turns to us for support. Sign up today at makingstrideswalk.org. Together, we can finish the fight against breast cancer.
Folks in TV land, and thank you, camera ladies, doing double time this morning, working with properties and the cameras and everything. We're glad to be here. You know, this Decimal Festival is really going to be great, the 13th annual one, and our good friend, the late Paul Powell, is such a wonderful person and maker of dulcimers, and I saw him perform one time, and he had the audience just wrapped in his hands, and they were listening very intently to Paul, and Paul stopped playing. He was right in the middle of a good tune. I don't remember what the tune was, but he stopped playing and looked down at his dulcimer, and he turned it over and looked in the back of it and looked on each end. He said, there must be a tune in there somewhere, and the audience just died laughing. He was so funny, a great, great friend, but it'll be something to look forward to. You know, I was thinking about the necessities of life the other day in connection with the history of Tullahoma and a lot of things and places that have been around for so many years. The necessities of like food, clothing, and shelter. We mentioned a little bit about shelter from time to time, and we're going to touch on clothing one of these days, and we've talked a little bit about Tennessee Apparel Company that made work clothes for so many years. But today I was thinking about the food industry, not the grocery stores, but the restaurants and the cafes and the places to eat. And as small as Tullahoma is, we have probably more facilities and more opportunities for dining out than I've ever seen in Tullahoma, and especially for a town this size that we have. And I couldn't begin to name all of them, but in recent years, for example, Applebee's and Ruby Tuesday's and Red Lobster and the Catfish Place, and more recently, Emile's and the downtown cafe that are just part of the many, many places they eat. I even noticed out at Lowe's the other day, they've got a hot dog stand out by their lumber department, and that's kind of interesting, you know. And the American Legion now, in that recent survey, got first place in the best steaks in Tullahoma, and it's a tribute to them. But, you know, going back further, when I was a little boy, I remember that my daddy would take me up to eat early morning breakfast before daylight at Blake's Cafe that was on West Lincoln Street, and either next door to or in the building where the Frames by You is in the 100 block of West Lincoln Street. And then further on down on that side of the street was the New Way Cafe many years ago. And at one time, Marvin Kirkus had the sweet shop there, later moving it over to where the downtown cafe is at the present time. And in the building located next door to Clyde Phillips Men's Store, the Gooches ran a restaurant called the City Cafe. And they were all real famous through the years, and other places that, people have enjoyed years ago. The Candy Kitchen we mentioned in a former program. We had several requests to do some more on the Candy Kitchen, and we'll do that sometime in the future. The Shamrock Cafe in the second block of North Atlantic Street was pretty famous, and then there were such boarding houses as Ms. Billingsley's, where Arnold Furniture Store is now, and Ms. Kersey's, that later was Ms. Walker's boarding house over on the east side of South Atlantic Street, where there's a paint store and KK's business is there, but the residences along that part of the street there at one time. And the corner of Wall Street and Grundy Street was a real good restaurant there at one time. So many places back through the ages and back through the years that meant so much to those folks that wanted to eat out, or bachelors that didn't cook for themselves and families. And you remember our good friend Vi that had her place down on, just across the viaduct, just off of Carroll Street, there behind the motor, Telehorn Motors, I believe, in that home, in her home. She was a great, great host. And just around the corner now, there's restaurant. Used to be, I think, CB Food Store, and a Dameron's restaurant there now. And across the street, there's the Dairy Queen, and Wendy's, and even the drive-in, the Moon's drive-in on Highway 55 that was so popular for so many years. And I noticed in the paper that the Jiffy Dip that was established by Bill and Dudley Tipps many years ago. Mr. Bradford's operated it for a number of years, and I understand he wants to go fishing, and it's one of the older drive-ins or eat-in places that's been so important to Tullahoma. In the 100 block of North Jackson Street, just behind Edward D. Jones Company, Darren Honeycutt's office building there, was a place that originally was the Banner Ice Cream Company that ceased operations back, I think, in the 30s. Well, anyway, the during Camp Forest from 41 to 46, there was a restaurant there called the Jackson Grill, and Mr. Joseph, Barcel Joseph from Nashville, was a restaurateur and operated it as the Jackson Grill. Another one where Bobby Sane's insurance office is on East Lincoln was called the Serval. Mr. Ed Travis from Mac Minimal, who operated the Dr. Pepper bottling plant here, built the Serval there. That was an important place. One end of it was just a short office space, and one end of that building was a photo studio. But the Serval was in the other end of it. And then there was our wonderful friends, the Daniels, that had the waffle shop on Wall Street for many years, and also operated the restaurant in the bus station where Sears had been for a long time. So we're glad to share this information with you, and like to say, this is not the end of the story, but there's a whole lot more to come, and everyone have a nice day.
Let the Smokehouse be your mountain getaway destination in beautiful Monteagle, Tennessee. Enjoy our cabins, restaurant, and old general store. Shop thesmokehouse.com featuring homemade barbecue sauces, jellies, and many other fine Tennessee products. Our live Music on the Mountain series features some of the best local and Nashville talent every Friday and Saturday night, 6:30 p.m. No cover, kids welcome.
If you want to be a parent, it doesn't matter how you play, what you wear, how you dance, or even what direction life takes you. You just need to be there. You don't have to be perfect to be a perfect parent. Thousands of teens in foster care don't need perfection. They just need you.
How long has it been since you raced a cheetah? Are your tornado creating skills getting rusty? Tired of being the only one in your neighborhood who hasn't built a dinosaur? Sounds like it's time to visit the Hands-On Science Center. The Hands-On Science Center is an indoor science playground. In this museum, please touch is the rule. Join us for weekly science demonstrations on space, lasers, lizards, rocks, and a whole lot more. No two visits are ever the same, so visit often to see our ever-changing exhibits and demonstrations. The Hands-On Science Center, 101 Mitchell Boulevard in Tullahoma.
Welcome back. Welcome back. It's always great to be here, and it's just about time. You can just get all fired up. And of course, it's just around the corner, Fired Up and Fit. And who better to explain what's going on and how exciting this is than our very own Dawn Hawley. Want to say hello?
Good to be here.
Yes.
Thank you.
Bedford County United Way Director. So it's always good to see you.
Always good to be here.
Yes, absolutely. And I can't believe it's time already for Fired Up and Fit.
Well, time flies
yeah,
when you're having fun.
It really does.
And we are. We're fired up for this Adventure 5K, and I think this is like the fourth year.
Yeah,
and
I was going to say.
It's your, and I mean, it has just flown by, and it
really
just continues to get better and better.
Sure, because there's so much going on this event.
There is.
Yeah. And it's coming up Saturday.
It is.
May 30th.
And that is just right around the corner.
It is.
So we always have a lot to do, of course, the week of an event. But, you know, one of the best calls that we made 4 years ago when we started this event was partnering with our Tennessee Fire and Codes Academy in the Bell Buckle area.
Sure.
It is a beautiful campus.
It is.
And so, you know, if you have never been, just the trip alone to visit that academy and go through that course is just amazing.
Yeah.
I had been on campus several times, but I had only gone to a certain point.
Sure.
And when we started planning this event, it is an amazing, beautiful campus.
It really is. It really is. So I encourage people just go out and just take the drive out there and just kind of view what's going on, because it is beautiful. Well, let's talk about this event. Now, at this point, registration is over.
Online registration is over, and we do not accept any more paper, you know, type registrations. Mm-hmm. And so the only way you can register is we do accept on walk-up registrations the day of.
Okay.
And so registration opens at 7 o'clock that morning, Saturday morning. Mm-hmm. And so we just encourage folks to walk up and register and get on the course and have a ball.
Sure. Now, although you say it's a 5K adventure challenge, you really don't have to get that physical and run.
You
know,
don't.
I'm lazy. You know, I'd probably crawl, but, you know.
It's we tell people you can run, you can walk, you can crawl.
Yeah.
Whatever best suits you is perfectly fine with us. You know, the obstacles are optional as well. And so I think people find it a little intimidating for the obstacles.
Yeah.
Some people absolutely love the obstacles.
Yeah.
But they are optional. Mm-hmm. So it's not a timed event.
Right.
No pressure on, you know, how you're going going to finish the race anything of that nature. Mm-hmm. We just want people to come and have fun. Get your family and friends involved. We have teams from businesses, local businesses that have brought their employees and used it as a team building, you know, effort, and just, it's just a ton of fun. Wow. I'm not a runner myself. I like to run, but I get a little bored with it, to be honest with you, just running. So the obstacles really kind of keep me entertained and kind of squish that monotony, per se. So it's a lot of fun.
It is. And there's something in for the kids. It's a 1 mile.
It's a 1 mile kids course. So it is for ages 5 to 12. If you are 5 to 8, you need a parent to accompany you as well. But 5 to 12, and then if you're 12 and above, you can register for the adult 5K.
Exactly. It's always exciting. It's always a good day and everything. So I think it's just a wonderful thing. There are a lot of sponsors that have come forward and helped you with this.
We do. We have amazing sponsors, and we certainly cannot put on an event of this nature without wonderful sponsors and volunteers. But the sponsors, you know, Heritage Medical Center has always been a huge sponsor of this event, and so I have to really give kudos to them. Heritage Medical Center, Shelbyville Times Gazette, Cooper Steel, Elaborate Images, Intersource, DirecTV just came on as a last minute sponsor as well. And so we are blessed with amazing sponsors to help with this event.
Individuals could actually go online and read about this, get more information about this event,
because we have just a snippet on the United Way Bedford, UnitedWayBedford.org, but we have a specialized event website, and that is firedupandfit.org, and that's fired up and then just the letter N, fit.org. Yeah, you can learn a lot more about that that event by going onto that event website and see pictures of the obstacles.
It's real cool.
I mean, it's really cool.
Yeah, it really is. Let's switch gears just a bit, because coming up on June 6th, there's another event that you're doing.
Okay. We have been holding a water safety day for probably, oh gosh, and I hate that I don't have these dates, probably the last 6 years. And it is in memory of Matthew Woods, who drowned in a family pool about 6 years ago. And so we partnered with the Shelbyville Fire Department and Shelbyville Parks and Recreation to hold a water safety day. And it is a really amazing event. I mean, we focus a lot on the fun and we have games and activities for the kids, but it is a large focus obviously on safety. I mean, we are coming up to the summer season where kids are around pools and water and lakes, and you know, we just try to assist them with some safety measures and really reiterate specifically to the parents that it really just takes a moment for that child to get out of your view and have have a devastation instead of a wonderful summer. And so we have a good time at that event, but obviously a large focus on safety, stressing safety.
That's right.
That's June the 6th. That's on the next Saturday.
Oh boy, busy.
Busy time.
And of course, Stuff the Bus comes up a little bit later.
Stuff the Bus comes up in July. In July, we will be getting out our, if you're familiar with the big yellow boxes, they look like the post office boxes. And so they're the big yellow boxes that we'll have strategically placed around Shelbyville and Bedford County in different banks and businesses.
That's right.
And you know, we have a lot of needs in our community.
Yeah, we do.
And so we partnered with our school system several years ago. I think this is our 8th year. And so 8 years ago, and just said, you know, what needs? And we were talking to teachers, and they just had kids that were coming in with no school supplies. And you know, how are kids able to learn and really focus on their their teachings if they don't have the proper supplies to even start them on that? So we typically collect an average of 7,000 to 8,000 school supplies. We have wonderful businesses who partner with us on that as well. Some of our local pencil companies donate some pencils. Sure. And so yeah. it is a very much a community-wide effort in helping our children succeed in education.
Oh, that's beautiful. Yes. That's beautiful. Yes. Our time has really flown, but I've got to mention the fact that Dawn, you are actually leaving the position. I can say this, I'm hoping.
Yes,
we're going to certainly miss you as the director there for the Bedford County United Way. I didn't really know this until actually this morning.
So
it's kind of a bittersweet thing for you.
It is bittersweet. I mean, United Way is such a wonderful organization.
Yes.
It touches so many lives.
Mm-hmm.
With all the programs, and those are just three programs that we mentioned today. That doesn't include our partner agencies do an amazing job of providing services to the community.
Yeah.
But I've been with United Way for 10 years, and it's been 10 beautiful, wonderful years.
Mm-hmm.
So it is bittersweet, but, great opportunity to work into a different capacity with the city of Shelbyville.
Yes, you have taken United Way to just levels beyond and such. You've
Thank
done so
you.
Well with it.
Thank
and
you.
I know I speak for so many people when I say that, Dawn. So good
so
luck in whatever your future endeavors will be. We're going to miss you.
I'm certainly going to miss y'all as well, but I will still be around.
You're going to be around.
I will be around.
Yeah.
So.
Wow. So, I didn't know that. So, congratulations on your new position.
I appreciate that.
Absolutely. Again, Fire to the Fit, that's coming up on Saturday, May 30th. And just take a look around for the website there. They've got all of that beautiful information there about that event, other events coming up as well. So, it's been Dawn Hawley right here from Bedford County United Way, the director, as she's leaving in the very near future. So thank you for watching this segment of Living. Stay tuned. They'll be back with more right after this.
Oh, hello, ladies and gentlemen. This is the paint. I just knocked a tree over. This is the paint doctor. I got the color wheel. Now, you know what a color wheel is? It is the wheel at the paint works where you pick all your colors to paint your room. It could be a multicolored beard. It could be a underarm fan. You never can tell. One thing we do know is that it's time to paint. You know, you can make your wife very happy if you go to your house and paint some rooms, or you paint the outside of the house, the inside of the house. It makes them feel very good because you work hard for them, and they like that. All women like to see their man sweat, you know? They do. Honeydew is what they do. And you get to do it too. So you go to the Paintworks at 1960 North Washington Street, and you see Dabbit Aikkonen over there, and he's the real paint doctor. He fix you up with color. It's so nice when the color is right. Go to Paintworks today, Martin Senor. See, Martin Senor, right there. Martin Senor out of the Paintworks. Bye, and we see you next time. I'm burning up.
You know what, guys? There's a lot of tree branches and dry brush over here. We should probably move the bonfire over there.
I'm guessing Smokey liked that idea.
Here we are, folks.
Boy.
It's wild and crazy here because my wild and crazy friend, Charlie Allen, has just shown up. And he has a lovely lady with him today, Miss Angie Lee. And I'm just glad that the both of you are here. See? Look there.
Well, I'm
aren't
darned.
Aren't they good looking? Look at that right there. What are the two of you into? Y'all, Charlie's been telling me you've been writing together.
Yes. We've been writing, singing.
Dancing, playing.
We haven't done a lot of dancing.
A little bit. No, I ain't seen her dance yet.
Ain't seen her dance yet?
No, I don't think she can dance. I mean,
we're going to have to crank it up and see what kind of moves she's got.
Not many.
Maybe got back.
Maybe doesn't.
So what are you into? Really, seriously?
Well, we're writing a record for her right now. I'm trying to get it together. And she loves traditional country. she worked with a great person, Waylon Jennings, on the road for a while, and she could probably tell you a little bit more about it than that. But I don't, you know, we're working on a great record. We'd love for you to write with us.
Oh, that's appreciate that. Did you know Nikki?
Yes.
Nikki Mitchell?
Yes.
Yeah, Nikki and I were friends.
What a great woman. Yes.
She's a wonderful
Absolutely
lady.
Woman.
And Jesse.
I haven't met Jesse. I've seen Jesse walking up down the road a couple of times, and I sort of figured that when somebody like that is out in the country walking up down the road, the last thing they want is to be bothered by somebody like me.
Well, she would have probably been glad you stopped.
But when Nikki first opened her business, you know, she came on the show a lot, and we helped her promote that. And then we helped her promote when she had Jamie Johnson down there.
Yes.
And of course, I'd still go to the restaurant down there and see Mike and eat their food because their food down there is phenomenal.
Yeah.
And Gretchen Wilson. I've seen a lot of people down there. Gretchen Wilson comes down and plays every now and then at the River. And
that's awesome.
And Richard Smith and Don Jones and just different ones, you know, come through there and play on Friday and Saturday nights. And, you know, it's great to have venues like that where you can see very, very, very respected and talented people in a close personal environment. And it's, you know, it's a lot of fun.
It is. I mean, and I think... Angie sings really well, and her heart's in it, you know. Big difference, you know.
Well, she's pretty enough to be there.
Thank you.
You know, it's kind of funny.
She's got more hair than we do.
It shouldn't make a difference, but it does.
It does. In most cases, it does. Yeah.
Yeah. So. Ask KT Oslin, she'll tell you.
I love KT.
KT's probably one of the greatest female singers to me that's blown through Nashville, but you know, she just a little bit heavy, a little bit big.
That ain't right.
Well,
she still sings good.
But it doesn't make any difference to people like you and me, but to the music industry, it does.
Tough business.
They put that belt buckle on the next good-looking thing that walks down the road. Ask Mutt Lang whether that works for you or not.
You know, I had the pleasure to do something with Mutt Lang in Orlando with the Backstreet Boys and NSYNC.
Uh-huh.
I actually got to see him work, and it was amazing.
He's phenomenal.
Amazing.
And Shania's back out there doing some stuff, and I'm glad for her.
Yeah.
So you're working on an album?
We are. We're working on an album. I've been out of music for about 2 years, 2.5 years, and Charlie has convinced me,
drug
me back out into it.
Yes.
And I'm very glad. It seems like it's the right place at the right time.
Good.
And we've been doing some things, you know, at 41 South, the traditional night. Uh-huh. I'm going to have to get you up there and start really conducting this.
Yeah, well, we can do that. We can do that.
Love what you do. And I think you're really.
Well, I'll tell you what we need to do. We got 4 minutes right now.
Oh, I see that. She put the number up.
She put the number up there. So I'll sing one for us.
Don't you realize what you've done? Thinking you're the only one. As the tears come falling down. Always when you're not around. And I'm here all by myself.
think love works like that. You broke my heart and hurt me bad. And I'd be a fool to take you back. And I don't think love works like that.
That's great.
No, we ain't finished with it. We're working on it.
You're never finished with one, Charlie. I got one. I've been writing with him for 3 years, and he ain't finished with it.
We've got some good stuff we started. I remember the last.
Listen, we got 30 seconds to get out of here. Thank you
you're
so
welcome.
Much for
Thank
being
you
here
for having us.
And sharing your wonderful voice
Thank
and
you.
Your presence with us. Great song, Charlie. It's always a pleasure, my
always
friend.
Always a pleasure
always
seeing
fun.
You, too.
And you look for these two because big things are getting ready to happen
yeah,
right
yeah.
here. I can tell. I can see a little George and Tammy right here if you look real close. Close your eyes and visualize.
What a compliment.
Folks, we're out of here. We'll be back next week. Thank you very much for being with
God
us.
God bless you.
God bless you.